This is a Friday Shoes production. This is lesson 4-8 on page 225 in our books. And the target is I can graph dilations on a coordinate plane. Dilations, the word dilation you may have heard from your eye doctor, where they dilate your eyes or enlarge your pupils so they can see inside your eyes. In math here, it says this, the image produced by enlarging or reducing a figure is called a dilation. A dilation image is similar to the original figure, meaning that its corresponding lengths on the two figures are proportional and the angles are equal or congruent. The center of the dilation is a fixed point used for measurement when altering the size of the figure. The ratio of a length on this image to a length on the original figure is the scale factor of the dilation. We call the image the second picture that you draw. So you can see right here we have A, B, C, D. We call that the original. The one we're going to draw is called the image. So let's try one. Copy polygon ABCD, and you can just watch me do it here, shown on graph paper. Then draw the image of the figure after a dilation with a center A by a scale factor of 2. So we're going to enlarge it by 2, or what we like to say is 2 times it, make it 2 times bigger. So what's the first step? Well, draw ray AB, as seen here, extending into the edges of the grid. And you can see I did AB, I did AC, and I did AD. I did all of them. And then, using a ruler to locate point B, or prime, B prime is what we call that, that little symbol there, the quote, or the quote mark. So, use a ruler to locate point B prime on ray AB, and you can see that's right here, such that AB prime is 2 times the length of regular AB. So, you're going to make it 2 times this length right here, which makes it 2 units instead of 1 unit. Lastly, repeat all those steps for C and D. A will actually stay in that same location. And then draw a polygon, A prime, B prime, C prime, D prime. Notice the primes are on the image, which is the second figure we draw. So the image in black there is the one that we're actually drawing with a scale factor of 2. So you notice it's actually 2 times larger than the original. If you look at each length of the sides, for instance, AD right here is half the size of A prime D prime. All right, you try it. Draw and label a large triangle. Now, here's the thing. I'll actually do this for you because you probably don't have graph paper there. So just watch me do this. Draw and label a large triangle, XYZ, on grid paper. Then draw the image of the triangle XYZ after a dilation with center X and scale factor 1/4. So watch what I do here. Oops. That's actually our figure after the dilation. So look at XYZ. Pretend that red one's not there. If you look at XYZ, you'll see that the length from here here, all the way down, is, let's see here, 8 units. So we had 8 units. I'm going to multiply by 1/4 to get how long it has to be after the dilation. So we're really just multiplying by this number here. And there it is. It's going to be 2 units. And if you noticed, this from X to Y is now only 2 units. We did the same with XZ. If you notice XZ from here to here, it's going to be 1/4. This is actually 12 units. And now if we take 12 times 1/4, basically you're dividing by 4, you have 3 units. And that's how long X prime Z prime is. So the red one is your image, and it has the prime symbols on it. The original is your XYZ, the black figure there. All right, set an example one, if you remember this one right here. If point A actually had coordinates of 0, 0, so if we made this the origin, this location right here, the origin, then the table below lists the coordinates of corresponding points on the original figure and its image. Notice that the coordinates of the image are basically taking the scale factor A and multiplying it by X and Y. the values. So you see here, all they're doing is taking, if we do a scale factor of 2, we're just multiplying this times 2, this times 2, this times 2, and this times 2 to get to our primes over here. That's what they're showing you here. That's really all you're doing. I kind of been saying it as I go along here. All you're really doing is taking your scale factor, multiplying it by each coordinate, and then you are getting your image coordinates. Let's try it out. It says to find the coordinates of the vertices of an image after dilation with center 0, 0, multiply the x and y coordinates by the scale factor. Again, just reiterating what we've been discussing here as we go through. So here's two. Graph triangle JKL with vertices 3, 8, 10, 6, and 8, 2 for JK and L respectively. Then graph its image, which would be J prime, K prime, L prime, after a dilation with a scale factor of 1 half. So all we're going to do is take this 1 half, this number here, 0.5, 1 half, whatever you want to call it, and literally multiply it by each one of these here. When I say each one, I mean each one inside. Both numbers, you're going to multiply by 1 half. Yes, you can use your calculator if you like. So what's our first step? Again, we're going to take the coordinates and multiply by a half. Then we're going to graph both images on the same axis, which you'll see here. So here's the original. And after we multiply everything by 1 half, here's what you end up with. And here's what it would look like on a graph. You can see the original is the blue. So this is the original right here in the blue. And the green here is after you multiply it by a half. And notice it shrinks. All right, you give it a shot here. I've actually created a couple for you. What it says to do is find the coordinates of the image of JKL after a dilation with each scale factor, then graph JKL and JKL prime. So you can watch me do these. I'm guessing you don't have graph paper, and I'll give you a worksheet in class to do when you get here with graph paper. So scale factor of 3. We're going to take JKL, which is located right here. Those three locations, I've already plotted it down here on the graph. You can see it. And what we're going to do is we're going to take those and scale factor them by 3, meaning multiply them by 3. So we're literally going to take each one of those and multiply by 3. Notice what happens. I'm going to multiply each one of them by 3. So these will be the new locations of these points. So JKL in black down there is already plotted. Now we're going to plot the new ones, the J prime, K prime, and L prime. And here's what it would look like. If I can get it to go. There we go. So those are the new locations. That's 9, 9, 18, 9, and 18, 0 for L prime. And notice it has grown. It actually blew up, meaning it got bigger, because it's a scale factor of 3. And just to prove that everything's perfect, we have the little lines to show you. Those should always line up from the origin or wherever the dilation is occurring from, in this case, 0, 0. All right, let's take a look at C here. Same thing. We have scale factor of 1/3, and we're going to multiply that by each one of those numbers right there. And, of course, we're going to get the points. JKL is already drawn for you. But notice when you multiply by 1/3, when you multiply by 1/3, everything gets smaller here. So now you have 1, 1, 2, 1, and 2, 0. So here's what that looks like. Ooh, we get that red up there. Notice how it's tiny now. So those are the new locations, 1, 1, 2, 1, and 2, 0. And then, of course, we have the yellow lines to show that they're all lined up. So in this one, we had a scale factor of 3. It got blown up. It's bigger. The image is bigger. And scale factor 1/3, it actually got smaller. So let's look at this last statement down here. It says if you examine the scale factors that we just did, and this one was 3, and this one was 1/3, and the images produced after the dilations, example 1 and 2, take a look. These and other examples suggest the following. A dilation with a scale factor greater than 1 produces an enlargement. So in the first one, we had 3. That's larger than 1, so you're going to get an enlargement, an image that is larger than your original figure. How about the second one? A dilation with a scale factor between 0 and 1, meaning a fraction of 1, will produce a reduction, an image that is smaller than the original figure. So we had 1/3, so therefore it's going to be a reduction. It's going to shrink. You may say it shrinks. That's something you might want to write in your notes there. All right, last page here. It says find and classify a scale factor. Take a look at the quadrilateral VZXY prime. It's a dilation of quadrilateral VZXW. Find the scale factor of the dilation and classify it as an enlargement or reduction. So here's the original in blue. That's the original. And then what happens is it gets larger. So I can right now just look and say, well, we always start with the letters VZXW without the primes. The second, you blow it up or you shrink it, and then you have a second figure. In this case, it's being blown up. So I already know it's an enlargement. I can call it an enlargement. But how are we going to find the actual scale factor? How do you determine the scale factor? Well, here it is. It says write a ratio of the x or y coordinate of one vertex of the dilation to the x and y coordinate of the corresponding vertex of the original figure. So use, in this case, they're going to use y coordinates of the v and the v prime, negative 2, 2, and negative 5, 5. We're going to take the y coordinates. And the y coordinate is the second coordinate right here. It doesn't matter which one you use. You can use the x coordinate or the y coordinate. You're going to end up here, just because it's positive, they're using it. You have 5 over 2. The way to remember this is take the second image, or the image, which is the prime image, and put it over the original. So image over original. You might want to remember that. Image over original will get you scale factor. So in this case, the scale factor is 5 over 2, and since 5 over 2 is greater than 1, that's 2.5. The dilation is an enlargement, which you can kind of see by the picture. But if you didn't have the picture and you just had a scale factor, you can see that's going to be an enlargement because it's greater than 1. All right, you give it a shot here. This one you can do. You don't have to have graph paper. Try to figure out if it's an enlargement or reduction and what the scale factor is. Come back, check with me in a second. All right, it says triangle ABC prime is a dilation of triangle ABC. Find the scale factor of the dilation and classify it as an enlargement or a reduction. All right, right away, I know blue is the original, green is the image. Blue is the first thing, green is the second. So we took blue and we reduced it. So I know it's a reduction already, just by the image that I can see. But what is the scale factor? Well, let's take and use, it doesn't matter which one, I'm just going to take and use the coordinates for B and B prime. So B, if you look, is, let's start at the origin, it's going to be negative 4 up 3. And B prime is going to be negative, let's see here, that's almost in between. So I don't know if I really want to use B. See how I did that? And I go, I don't think so, because it's not really on a nice cross here. So I'm going to use A, because I can see that those actually cross at those crosshairs. Easy to locate. I'm glad I made that mistake in front of me, because I can see it's a lot easier to use A now. A and A prime. Oops. So let's do that. What is that going to be? So A would be, let's see here, negative 3, negative 3. And A prime will be negative 2, negative 2. Now remember what I said, you do image over original. So I'm going to do A prime over A. And it doesn't matter which ones you use, either the x values or the y values. Because they used the y values last time, I'm going to use the y values this time. So we take this number right here, which is negative 2. That's on the prime. Remember, we got to start with the prime, and then we do it over the original, which is negative 3. That right there, the two negatives, makes a positive. So our scale factor is going to be 2/3. All right, how about this one? An optometrist dilates a patient's pupils by a factor of 5 over 3. If the pupil before dilation has a diameter of 5 millimeters. Find the new diameter after the pupil is dilated. Well, again, all we have to do is take the scale factor and multiply it by the value that you're looking to dilate. So it says it in words. It says the size of the pupil after dilation is 5/3, which is 1 2/3 the size of the pupil before dilation, which means it's going to get larger. So all we're going to do is take 5/3 and multiply by 5. And if you do that on a calculator, you'll see that the dilated pupil will then grow to be 8.33 millimeters. And they say 8.3 because they round to the nearest tenth. How about you give it a shot here? It says Dante uses an image of his dog as the wallpaper on his computer desktop. The original image is 5 inches high and 7 inches wide. If his computer scales the image by a factor of 5/4 or 1 1/4, 1.25, what are the dimensions of the dilated image? So the original is 5 inches and 7 inches, and now we're going to scale factor it and dilate it by 5/4. Simple. Take our original amounts, 5 inches and 7 inches, multiply by 5/4, and you'll get the new values after the dilation of the image. And those will be 6 1/4 inches and 8 3/4 inches. That's it. Of course, you can rewatch the video or read the examples in the book again, because I just did them. Or you can check out the personal tutor videos on the online textbook. And as usual, this has been a Friday Shoes production.